So earlier this year, FX Home released a new version of Hitfilm. Now it's just Hitfilm, as Hitfilm Express doesn't really exist anymore. Now because of this move, FX Home faced quite a lot of backlash and hate from the beginner's video editing community. But the question is the new version of Hitfilm really that bad? Well, let's find out. Apart from that logo, which is definitely a downgrade from the previous version, I mean, just look at it, it looks like a play button. The interface is pretty much the same. The light theme has been removed though, and it now only has one theme. To me, honestly, it looks more like Premiere Pro's interface, which might be a pro or a con depending on who you ask. Oh, and there's a new splash screen when you launch the app, because why not? Every other app does it, so I guess we'll do it too, right? The colors and the icons have definitely improved quite a bit from the previous versions though. Upon comparing both the latest and the older versions of Hitfilm, I can confirm that the only new addition to effects were the scopes. Nothing else has changed, and thankfully nothing else has been removed, so that's a good thing. One major addition to the new version of Hitfilm though is the library panel, from where you can access tons of music, sound effects and video templates. Should be pretty handy for run and gun video editing. Although the free version of Hitfilm doesn't really have a lot of those, and the ones which are there don't really sound that good, to be honest. In terms of performance, I think both perform very similar. I did notice that the newer version is a little bit slower than the older version, but the difference is so insignificant that it really doesn't matter. So if nothing really has changed, then why all the hate? Well, let's start with where it all began. On July 14, 2021, FX Home, the creator of Hitfilm, was acquired by Artlist, a UK-based company which is pretty famous for their royalty-free audio services, and they aim at creating a video editing software for the next-gen video editors. I really don't know what that is supposed to mean, but okay. So their goal is to create a video editor for the next-gen video editing creators by combining the Artlist library and the power of video editing provided by Hitfilm. So I think that's a good idea, but it also sparked quite a bit of backlash from the community, as I said before. Now they turned Hitfilm into a subscription-based model, similar to what DaVinci Resolve is doing. There is a free version of Hitfilm, just like it used to be back in those Hitfilm Express days, with some limitations. It's just that you'll have to upgrade to the Hitfilm Pro or create a suite to get access to all of Artlist's library and all the pro features. Now all this is good and great, but the main reason why FX Home has been getting all this hate is because they completely abandoned Hitfilm Express, and the people who updated to the newer version of Hitfilm completely lost their access to the plugins which they paid for because of some kind of licensing issues. And the worst part is, even after they installed the previous version of Hitfilm, they still can't use those licenses. That's really crazy. The other drawback is the limitation when it comes to exporting videos. Now you can only export up to 1080p on the free version of Hitfilm, so no more 2K or 4K video exports. However, you can still edit a 4K footage, it's just that you'll have to stick to 1080p as the maximum resolution in your project settings, otherwise you'll get the watermark. Hitfilm now also restricts the ability to create output presets, and you're only getting 20 songs, 20 sound effects and 5 video templates in the free version of Hitfilm. The watermark has been a big nuisance to a lot of folks ever since the new version of Hitfilm was released. People would get random watermarks on their videos even if they never used any premium features. While we're on the topic of watermarks, it seems like Hitfilm has fallen in love with the word upgrade. As soon as you open the Hitfilm app, the first thing you see is, you open the editing window and you see a big fat. And if that's not enough, take a look at this. I mean, sure, you want your free users to upgrade, but then these big bright orange buttons just look extremely ugly and just are an awful sight to look at. I mean, take a look at DaVinci Resolve, right? The pro effects are marked in such a subtle way. They're not right in your face, unlike what Hitfilm is doing. The first time when I looked at the new version of Hitfilm, it reminded me of one of those horrible Android apps which ask you for an upgrade every single time you want to do something in those apps. So at the end of the day, the question is the free version of Hitfilm worth using anymore? My answer is yes, definitely. If you're just starting out and you really don't care much about 4K video editing, then this is still a great option. Although there are other alternatives to Hitfilm, which honestly are quite better than Hitfilm. But one field where Hitfilm really shines is how simple it is for beginners to use. The interface is really well defined and everything is just clicks away. And as I mentioned before, it has a very close resemblance to the interface of Premiere Pro. So if you ever get out of Hitfilm and dive into Premiere, you shouldn't really have any problem adapting to the interface of Premiere Pro. Hitfilm also works quite well on low-end computers as opposed to its free rival DaVinci Resolve, which struggles quite a bit on low-end hardware. So as long as FX Home doesn't restrict any further features in the free version of Hitfilm and gets all the watermark related bugs resolved, I can still recommend it to all the people who are looking out for a simple and efficient video editor to start their editing journey with.